Hello, this introductory video will help you become familiar with R-Instat and its features by guiding you through a simple analysis of a well-organized dataset. Let's get started. When you open R-Instat, it looks like this. To open a dataset from the library, you can either choose File, Import from Library, or click on Import from Library on the start screen. Choose the ggplot package and the first dataset called Diamonds. Once a dataset is selected, you can see that the OK button is now enabled, as is a second help button just below the list of datasets. Click on that button to get information about the datasets, including a description of the data and details about the different variables. The Diamonds dataset is used by Hadley Wickham, the author of ggplot2, for many examples in his documentation. Return to the dialog, select the Diamonds dataset again, and click OK to open it. The data appear on the left-hand side. Looks a little like a spreadsheet. Look at the bottom of the data frame to see how many rows there are. Here, you can see that the window is currently showing the first 1,000 of 53,940 rows. We use the scroll bar to go to the bottom of the first 1,000 rows. Then, use the single arrow to move to the next 1,000 rows, or the double arrow to go straight to the end of the dataset. There are 10 columns of data in this file. These are the variables, of which 7 are numeric and 3 are categorical. R calls categorical columns factors, and they are denoted by an F after the column name. These factor columns are ordered. For example, the second column, namely the cut of the diamonds, ranges from fair to ideal. Ordered factor columns are denoted by OF after the column name. Next, you will usually use the prepare menu to organize the data. But here, our data are already well prepared, so we go straight to the describe menu to start the analysis. Start by using some simple graphs to give an overview. Use describe one variable graph. This opens a simple dialog. Use the down arrow on the Add button to select Add All. Alternatively, you could just select all the columns using Ctrl A and then click Add. In the dialog, the radio button has changed from facets to combined graph. That is because the selected variables are of different data types. Some are categorical, that is factors, while others are numeric. Press OK to give the results. Click on Maximize in the output window to get a bigger view. The analysis in R has detected which variables are categorical and shown them as bar charts, compared with box plots for the numeric variables. Often, the results from using a dialog can be improved, so don't be afraid to go back and try more options. You could use the same menu options as before, but there's a quicker way. Clicking on the dialog icon on the toolbar brings up the last dialog you used, while the down arrow gives a drop-down list of the last 10 recently used dialogues. We want the most recently used dialog, So, simply click on the icon. The dialog remembers the setting just as you left it. This is often convenient, especially if you're making small changes. It is also easy to start again by using the reset button at the bottom of the dialog to clear all the settings. We do this. Then, select the last six variables, starting with depth, to put into the receiver. As these are all numeric columns, the radio button on the right stays on facets. Now, click OK and maximize in the output window. This shows a faceted graph. It doesn't look very nice. Can you see why? By default, the y-axis is the same for all the graphs. This is often what is wanted for a multiple graph, because you don't then need each axis to be labeled. However, it isn't what is needed here. The different variables have very different scales, and we need to reflect this in the graph. There's an easy fix. Return to the same dialog again and click on the Graph Options button. You now see a sub-dialog with just two tabs. One tab allows you to change the type of graph. So, you would use this to get a histogram instead of a box plot, for example. The other tab changes how the graph is displayed. Press on the tab labeled Display, and then click on the Free Scale axis. Press Return, then OK again to give the graph. Click on Maximize in the output window to get a bigger view. Now, our box plots are clear, and each axis has its own scale. Often, analysis involves numerical as well as graphical summaries. For this, we use Describe, one variable, Summarize. This dialog has three tabs that summarize the data in different ways. Use the default view. Select all the variables again, as with the graph dialog, then press OK to give the results. These results, just like the graph, are different for the numeric and factor variables. On some machines, as here, the results don't look neat. We make the output window wider. That's better. For the numeric variables, they provide the mean together with the five summaries used in a box plot. The minimum, first quartile, median, third quartile, and the maximum. For a factor, the frequencies at each level are given, as in the bar charts. We now move to some more ambitious analysis. Go to the Describe, two variables, graph dialog. First, use the three variables, depth, table, and price. Click OK to show the graph and maximize. The results show the density of each variable on the diagonal. The three correlations are on the upper part of the display, while the two variable scatter plots are on the lower part. Return to the dialog by clicking on the View / Edit Last Dialog icon to create a second graph. Add the cut factor to the color optional receiver. It looks quite nice in color. And now, the correlations and the scatter plots are given separately for each level of the cut factor. Let's make one more graph. Return to the dialog again. This dialog allows both factors and numeric variables. Using the double click this time, we add the factor variables color and clarity to the first variables box. What do we get then? Once you have the graph, click on the blue maximize link in the output window to get a better view. From here, click on the file menu to save a copy of the graph to include in a report. Our next activity is about correlations. Correlations were given as a sort of extra in the two variables graph dialog we just used. But now we look at additional correlations in more detail. We examine the relationship between the data in the X and Z variables. The diamond data rhelp file accessed earlier via the import from library dialog explained that X is the length in millimeters, 0 to 10.74, and Z is the depth in millimeters, 0 to 31.8. Go to the describe 2/3 variables correlations dialog. Put the variables X and Z into the two receivers. RInstat needs to know both variables before doing a correlation, so the OK button is not enabled until they are entered. This dialog has an option subdialog to add further option choices. Click on it. Select the pairwise plot, then click Return. Back on the main dialog, click OK and maximize the graph in the output window. The resulting pairwise plot shows the correlation between the length and depth of the diamonds is very high, which is not surprising. But there are some very odd values. These have been circled in red. It looks as though some diamonds have a depth of 0, which is obviously impossible. And there's at least one value that is 3 times larger than any other. With 53,000 values, it is perhaps not surprising that there are some oddities to investigate. To better understand these oddities, we now check on the outliers. For this investigation, go to the Describe One Variable Frequencies dialog. Select the Z variable. OK is now enabled, so press it. Examining the results, 20 diamonds have a depth of 0, and no others are less than 1 millimeter. This is difficult to understand. At the other end, the second largest diamond is 8 millimeters deep. Then, one is 31.80 millimeters. This is very odd. Perhaps it should have been 3.18? What to do about outliers is an important topic in data analysis. We look briefly at the results without them to see if excluding them is a good solution. The ability to filter data is an important and powerful facility in R, and hence in RInstat. It is a slightly more complicated dialog. Right-click and choose Filter Rows. In the Filter dialog, choose Define New Filter. In the sub-dialog, choose Z and then give the condition as greater than 0 and add the condition. Then use Z again, put less than 10 and add this condition as well. Then return and accept as a filter by pressing OK. The row numbers on the left are now in red to indicate a filter is in operation. At the bottom, the numbers indicate there are now 21 values less as expected from the results earlier. Return to the correlations dialog. It remains as before, which is convenient, so simply press OK and then maximize from the output window. The results look better, though there remain several more possible outliers to investigate. The change in the display from omitting so few observations shows the importance of paying attention to checking the data quality before doing too much analysis. You can continue exploring the Describe menu with this data set and produce more tables and graphs that explore the data. The next video introduces dialogues in the Prepare menu using a second data set from the R Instat library. At some stage, you may find our Tutorial 1 Reflections video useful.